Conventional large-scale agriculture has harmful consequences for us and our environment. We're told that it's the only way, and we just have to live with these side effects. But is this really true? What if there was a way that we could grow safe, nutritious food for everyone without trashing the planet? Hi, I'm Dr. Wendy Seabrook from Learning from Nature. I've dedicated the last 20 or so years researching and supporting farmers and gardeners to use alternative ways of growing food that reduce the costs for us and our environment. Contrary to what we are told, the green and clean future of agriculture won't be huge monocultures mass producing food, with farmers driving enormous tractors and using new technologies like drones to grow crops with fewer chemicals. A different future with food grown in thriving ecosystems will inevitably unfold, because farmers are struggling to pay their bills, to maintain yields, and to recover from one extreme weather event after another. Many farmers for a long time have suffered low yields because they can't afford all of the fertilisers and pesticides required by conventional agriculture. But now, with energy, fertiliser and other input costs escalating, virtually all farmers around the world are struggling to pay for the inputs needed to maintain yields. Large-scale corporate farms can better endure these costs, but like everyone else relying on monocultures and conventional agricultural practices, their production systems have limited capacity to withstand and recover from flooding rains, from droughts, extreme heat, and the unusual pest and disease outbreaks that farmers are now experiencing. So what is the solution? The setting for the future of agriculture is radically different. People are transforming their land into thriving ecosystems, producing safe and nutritious food, whether growing in a backyard in Wales, a community garden in Boston, a small holding in India, or even a large farm in the American Midwest. In the future, we will no longer rely on monocultures, and the fertilizers and pesticides required by conventional agriculture to feed and protect our crops. We will instead grow diverse crops and utilize plants, animals, insects, and other living organisms to create connections that deliver ecological services. For example, plants help us reduce soil compaction. They provide food and shelter for the beneficial insects controlling our pests. Plants also supply leaves, root tissues, and root exudates to feed the microbes and the invertebrates and other living organisms in our soil. Grazing and browsing livestock of all shapes and sizes help us get the wealth of plant materials recycled in our soil. By growing an abundance of plants and skillfully creating multiple layers of vegetation, we will capture more solar energy to fuel the ecosystems in our farms and gardens. We'll grow trees and shrubs to weave extra layers of vegetation, fruit, nuts, fodder and forage for our grazing and browsing animals. Trees create biodiverse habitat, but they also provide physical protection from drought, wind, sunburn, and extreme temperatures. In the future, we will grow food in dark brown and crumbly soil with aggregated minerals and organic matter. These are the unmistakable signs of a well-fed and diverse community of soil organisms who are busily recycling nutrients and naturally making them available to our crops for reuse. Water readily infiltrates and is stored, and excess drains down through our soil, reducing the damage caused by droughts and flooding rains. By reconstructing the complex web of connections, enabling the ecosystems within our gardens and farms to function, we can once more rely on nature's free ecological services. Insects, birds, reptiles, and mammals that used to be common are commonplace once again. It becomes more affordable for us to grow food, and we fortify our vegetable gardens, orchards, and fields to more easily withstand the storms of climate change. Let's cultivate this ecological story together and grow enough healthy food for everyone without trashing the planet.